A symbol of French revolutionary spirit and engineering, the 304.8-meter Eiffel Tower is a reflection of Gustave Eiffel's visionary mind. Every year, it welcomes 7 million visitors to see the engineering masterpiece, which has been enjoying the crown of the world's tallest structure for 41 years. And it comes as no surprise when you wonder, how was this beautiful masterpiece of ironwork made? Today's video will cover everything about the making of the Eiffel Tower. Keep watching till the end because this tower faced a lot of problems during its construction. The Eiffel Tower was built not to exist. It had to be a temporary structure meant to last for 20 years only. Sounds surprising, right? But why was it so? Made to stand specifically for the World's Fair in 1889, it was intended to be dismantled afterward for two main reasons. Firstly, many Parisians who loved classical architecture disliked the tower's latticework and soaring height. Secondly, there were many safety risks involved in using wrought iron on such a large scale. Even though both the French government and Eiffel, the mastermind behind the tower, were confident about this new concept, it was still considered risky. So, building it temporarily could be a test run to see if the design held up over time. Now, when and how it all started. The idea of building the Eiffel Tower emerged when, in the late 18th century, Paris was excited about an upcoming grand-scale celebration, the 1889 World's Fair. The French government planned for a dazzling display of inventions, cultures, and global wonders. But something special was missing. They needed a centerpiece to greet the international audience and show France's greatness, maybe a unique landmark the world had never seen. So, the government announced a big competition for designing and building that wow grand structure. Architects across France gathered to participate in the competition. Out of hundreds of entries, one design stood out. It was the most unique and innovative idea. The Giant of Iron by Gustave Eiffel. Yes, it all started with the design of the Eiffel Tower. Gustave Eiffel's company, famous for building big things, introduced an even higher structure for the World's Fair. Gustave Eiffel's chief engineers, Coquelin and Nouguier, proposed the core concept of a massive 300-meter or 1,000-foot pylon with four latticework columns, an ambitious upside-down pyramid reaching for the sky. However, Eiffel wasn't satisfied with just a super-strong upside-down sky-high pyramid. He wanted to make it more appealing. Therefore, his competent architect, Stephen Sylvestre, added the beautiful arches at the base of this grand tower, and even integrated an elegant dome at the top. Beyond practicality, Eiffel wanted the tower to avoid looking like a giant metal pole. So, his team incorporated a crazy crisscross pattern of iron bars, like a massive web. This latticework not only made the tower look awesome, but also provided exceptional stability in strong winds. It might surprise you that, initially, the Eiffel Tower had a much fancier design. The architect wanted fancy stone bases for the legs, grand arches connecting them to the first floor, and even glass rooms on each level. The top could resemble a giant light bulb, with other decorative elements. Ultimately, they opted for a simpler approach but elegant design, which contributed to the tower's iconic look today. Choosing the right material was critical after the design was finalized. Eiffel and his team needed incredibly strong yet lightweight material. Steel was too bulky, and wood was simply not strong enough for such a massive structure. That's why they decided to use high-strength forged iron. Some engineers argued that wrought iron wasn't a reliable material for such a tall structure. But the team was confident in their selection because of their past experiences. To remove the excess carbon from iron, they decided to heat iron in special furnaces, and for rust resistance, they applied a thick coat of paint, which is still applied to the entire Eiffel Tower every 7 years. Ultimately, this material offered the perfect balance of strength and weight that the Eiffel Tower needed and proved Eiffel correct in his choice. Victory in the competition wasn't the finish line. Real challenges emerged when the construction work started in January 1887. Fortunately, they found the perfect solutions too. First, the soft soil of Paris couldn't serve as the most solid foundation for a giant tower. To tackle this issue, Eiffel's team spread out the tower's base with those awesome arches we mentioned earlier. This helped distribute the tower's weight evenly. It was like making this Iron Lady wear big snowshoes to avoid sinking in the snow. Second, ensuring stability was crucial. Eiffel's team addressed this by digging 4 deep foundation holes for the tower's columns, which were then filled with concrete to create an incredibly strong base that could support the entire structure. They even capped these foundations with decorative limestone for a touch of elegance. But stability wasn't just about the base. Eiffel's crew relied on an incredible 2.5 million rivets to hold everything together. Imagine building with a giant metal Legos, but way stronger. That's essentially what they did. Each rivet was heated red hot and hammered into place. This all aimed at joining the 18,038 pre-built pieces into a super strong structure, a staggering 7,300 tons of metal. But Eiffel wasn't after immediate strength. He knew metal expands when hot and contracts when cold. With a structure as vast as the Eiffel Tower, these temperature changes could cause the metal to warp or bend, which might compromise its stability. Eiffel addressed this problem by using slightly loose rivets when connecting the iron beams. This brilliant solution allowed for some movement of the metal pieces following the temperature changes, preventing undue stress on the entire structure. With up to 300 people on site, Eiffel opted for pre-making of metal parts at a giant workshop, like a massive Meccano set. This expert planning sped up construction significantly and ensured the pieces fit together perfectly. Putting these puzzle pieces together on site was another feat. Eiffel's team built guardrails for safety and used special moving platforms known as scaffolds. These scaffolds could be adjusted with the tower's growing height. But as the tower grew taller, transporting workers and materials became more difficult and dangerous. Traditional scaffolding couldn't help at such a height. Gustave Eiffel realized the seriousness of the issue when he was nearly stranded at the construction site due to a malfunctioning elevator. Therefore, sensing the need for safer transportation of workers, he devised an innovative system of mobile platforms. These platforms could rise along with the growing tower. Thus, workers could go to different work areas safely. With hundreds of workers employed at great heights, falls and accidents were still a major concern. Eiffel ensured workers' safety by implementing several other measures as well. These included using harnesses and safety lines and erecting guardrails around the construction site. For even greater precision, down to a single millimeter, they used special boxes filled with sand and jacks to move the giant metal beams. Once the first level was complete, innovative steam cranes that climbed the tower itself took over the lifting duties. It might sound scary, but these precautions and machinery resulted in minimum accidents during construction. Still, Eiffel's crew wasn't short of engineering headaches, and with this project, wind was a major concern. The hundreds of meter tower could act like a giant sail in the presence of a strong wind. Eiffel's clever solution saved it. He made the tower curve slightly at the top, like a pointy hat. This brilliant design helped the tower cut through the wind instead of catching it, making it much sturdier. Finally, with the extraordinary speed of engineering work, the entire Eiffel Tower was ready for the show on March 30, 1889, after only 2 years, 2 months, and 5 days to complete. This was incredibly quick, but not easy for such a large and complex structure. Initially, the Eiffel Tower wasn't everyone's favorite landmark. Believe it or not, many Parisians thought it looked like a giant metal mess. They worried it clashed with the city's beautiful buildings and wouldn't last long. Some even called it an eyesore. But it all proved wrong. The Eiffel Tower surprised everyone. It turned out to be super useful, with antennas for radio and other cool tech. Plus, people started to realize it looked pretty amazing, especially all lit up at night. Slowly but surely, Parisians fell in love with their quirky tower. Tourists flocked to see it, and soon the Eiffel Tower became a symbol of France, like a giant metal thumbs up to the world. building a giant metal dream wasn't cheap. The Eiffel Tower cost a whopping 7.8 million French francs back in 1889. That's like $44 million today. It was a big investment, but Eiffel was smart. He knew the tower would attract visitors and make money over time, which helped win over investors. And he was right, too. Today, the Eiffel Tower is a global icon. Millions visit every year, snapping photos and marveling at its engineering marvel. So, the construction story of the Eiffel Tower reminds us that even the most unusual ideas can become something incredible. Even if you face criticism or challenges, don't give up. Keep working hard and believe in your vision. Who knows? Your creation might just become a symbol of an entire nation someday, just like the Eiffel Tower did for France. Let us know in the comments below if you are impressed by this story of the Eiffel Tower. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to like and share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more exciting content.